Have you found it?
Its popularity is ever increasing.
This is Owen, Abbot of Armagh. The book is for him.
I remember, from the coronation.
I pray you did not have to endure much to reclaim this.
A small prize to ensure the High King's patronage.
What's this? Lord, you are chosen High King by God Almighty. These are pagans. I mean no disrespect.
We Norse have hardened shells, Abbot. It is why we are liked by so many.
I only mean to warn Flarn of the possible implications. Nothing more.
And I am well aware of them, Abbot.
I have spoken past what is right. I will take my leave. Lord, please excuse this clumsy intrusion.
No need. I am gladdened to see the book is back in good hands.
He is colorful.
I do not blame the Abbot for raising alarm. History dictates he has every reason to. What is your report?
I have dealt with the leader in the bark. You will have no more problems coming out of Dublin.
Then we shall turn our eyes to the problem at hand. Ulster is using its power to sway Connacht, an allegiance that must be snuffed before it takes flame. For that, we need to gain support from the other kingdoms. Speak with Kira. She will guide you in this.
I shall return to Dublin to gather men and resources for the march.
I welcome them. When we are strong enough, we'll meet at Knockfree and devise a strategy.
You were gone some time. What happened?
The book was in the hands of a strange cult. They procured it from Thorstein.
I was weak to spare him. My own son knew better.
Chin up, Bardith. We have come into favor with the High King.
I will feel better the day Flan's trust in me is not shadowed by doubt. Back to Dublin I go. Talk to Kira. We must gain favor with the other kings. Quickly.
Alleluia! Eivor! I reckon Flan and Barath have found common ground, seeing as you're still here.
They have.
Ara, and how much of your charm seeped into that conversation?
I merely showed the High King I'm a Norse he can trust.
It is more than that. You've certainly left your mark here. Sure, I think Flan is fond of you.
Is he the only one?
You're not shy, are you?
Just perceptive. We need to curry favor with as many kingdoms as we can. Flan said you could help with that.
Aye. The kings of Ireland have long sent their grievances to the High King's court in hopes their pleas be heard. Their problems range from petty squabbles to larger issues. I've taken the liberty of sifting through them, choosing the ones that might elicit the best response.
I see. The bigger the favor, the bigger the reward.
There you have it. Keep an eye out for pigeon coops. That's where I'll leave any noteworthy tasks. Help solve their woes, and the kings will pay tribute with the men and supplies we need to invade Ulster.
I should not be seen in this area. Cast about this land, my friend. Interesting.
Hey, wait!
Something's going on.
Stop, you!
Left is to leave. Lawn's renown grows. Show me what lies ahead. I need your eyes, my friend. The guards here are vigilant. Lots of plunder here. With the crew's help, we could get it back to the ship.
Such coward.
Treacherous pirates! Alas!
Give me a hand with this.
From the other side.
This little
boy. Give me a hand over here.
Halfway there.
Come after, Stirmar. Let's go. Sail! Set cut to the wind! Sail in!
Sigurd!
Thor, what's got into you?
Your end is right here.
some good loot here.
Give me a hand. All right, we have what we came for. Let's go.
Should garner some support.
Go! Ha!
I must take care. This fog.
At the ready.
The missing piece has arrived. Welcome, Eivor.
Lord, this has the looks of a Norse war camp. Plenty of stout-looking men.
The fruits of your labors, Eivor. The kings you've helped have sent men and more as tribute. You have my thanks.
Thank me later. A battle looms.
True enough. Your cousin awaits inside the tent of command. I'll soon follow to plan our next move.
Ah, Eivor. Look at me. Part of Flann's war council. Not bad for a Vikinger, eh?
You've gained his trust?
I wouldn't say that, no. He's a bit suspicious of me, in fact. But he needs my army, so he holds his nose.
Of course he does. Vikings smell.
My king.
We are ready to deliver Alec a weighty blow. But our enemies are now alerted, and will rally in greater numbers.
Cachalor Castle divides Ulster and Connacht. Taking it would isolate each from each.
Cachalor is a stepping stone to all the north. It is an imposing fortress atop a steep cliff. It must be ours.
But for that very reason, Lord, it will cost us dearly to storm it.
Loss of men is a price well paid. Victory will bring many more flocking to our cause.
Take care, King. Your ambition may overleap your reason.
What is your counsel, Eivor?
Cunning over courage. A single spy slips in and breaks the gate locks. Then our soldiers flood in.
It is worth the attempt. You seem to have a feel for this, Eivor. I select you as this single spy.
Eivor?
It's a good challenge.
We have a scout near the castle. She may be able to help you.
Those defenses could stop the guards. Survey the area, Zunin. They will attack on sight here. Hi, are you Flan's scout?
You are a bold adventurer to ask in these parts. Yes, I am.
How might I enter the castle?
Alone? You can try to climb its walls. A foolhardy move for such a small force.
Is there a way to enter unseen?
There must be a path below. Built a wily Viking, it could use their equipment to find a way in.
I am that. Thank you.
by Freya, this land is green. Now to open the gate for Flarth and his army.
Not much longer, Corpse!
With me! Here!
I'll take you!
Come, brothers! Let's end this!
Bravely done, Eivor. Cashelor will be ours.
I have your back. I count on you, cousin. Long, watch your flank.
Press on, Eivor. Press on.
King!
Hand me up in this!
Yours for the taking! Sack the castle!
Come, witch!
Stay back, you puny dead!
You!
charge!
Watch our flank!
Press on, Eivor! Press on! Space out.
Sláinte, to a battle well fought and blood well spilt.
To Ireland.
Skål.
Ah,
another cup, my king.
Where's our court poet? This deserves a song. Eivor, it is essential that you speak with her.
Kira, is she here?
I greeted her arrival. She will build my glory throughout Ireland. Her song will be repeated in every village and hamlet. You, Eivor, with your keen eye, can give details of my bravery. The bravery of all my soldiers, for her to craft a ballad.
I will give her your message, O brave king. Baleth, you deserve another drink.
And you as well. Come back for another before the night is out.
Better keep our eyes open.
Like hellfire itself.
Sure, sure.
Let's see you, old friend. You sing with conviction.
It is the mournful song of the Leofal, the ancient stone you saw at the coronation.
That stone, it seemed to... it...
The legend is that the stone will bring woe. But the song claims if Ireland came to peril, the stone would rain a storm of wonders.
From where would the song draw this wisdom?
I do not know, but my mother sang it. My mother's mother sang it as well. And her mother, and hers. Back to the very first woman of the Isle. The mere sound of the words connects me to my ancestors and this fertile soil.
You're lucky. I've left my land far behind.
You need not leave to feel the land change beneath you. That's why I'm stuck in this court like some sort of dancing goat.
Surely you can leave any time you wish.
I can, and I will. But not until Flann rules all Ireland.
Is he such a great man as that?
He understands that to be king is to be king of all. Though I'm pagan, he made me court poet. He respects the old ways.
I admire your passion.
Thank you for that. Not everyone is so appreciative.
I appreciate you for all your qualities, Kira.
I've got more than a fine voice for singing, if that's what you're asking. Is that what you're asking?
I'm asking if you'd like to take advantage of a Norse who finds himself alone with a bewitching Irish woman.
Ara, don't you have a way with words, Eivor? And I'm not saying never.
I understand. I all but forgot. Flann sent me to remind you to begin his ballad.
He needn't worry. I know my purpose here.
If it is as glorious as that song was lovely, Flann is certain to gain many followers.
Good night, Eivor. I'll see you in the morning. Slán.
Good night, Kira. A beautiful morning. Ah, Barith asked me to return to him last night. I should apologize.
Not again! Eivor, please.
Come. The army has been poisoned. Curse of Loki.
Speak, Harson! Who?
That's the man, my king!
You accuse Barith?
It's him what gave me the poison. 7 silver he paid.
The king of Dublin.
My king, I...
Only the Irish were poisoned. Your Danes are hale and hearty.
My lord.
Flattering words and servile gifts. All to mask treachery.
My lord, you know this cannot be true. Danes don't use poison. And Barith is no man of guile.
My king, it was him. He says to me, poison the feckin' Irish, he says. He threatened me life.
Silence!
Ah!
Take this man away.
No. I done nothing.
Kira, I chose to place you at my right hand because you see clear. Still, I cannot trust this Dublin Dane.
My king, I have faithfully served you.
Trust him better, lord.
I said silence. Danes often fight for either side. Barith, stay within these castle walls while I consider your position. I must first find care for my soldiers.
You well know, my king. I have a friend who can heal most any malady.
Ah. One of your scattered coven of forest-dwelling pagans.
Let me speak with her. She'll find a cure.
Ara, go. Take a soldier with you for protection.
I choose you as my soldier. Meet me at the stables, near the front gate.
Barith, you should be grateful your head is still upon your shoulders.
I am. By the gods, I am.
Come, let us find my friend Deirdre.
Who is this healer?
She is a druid. Wise, despite her youth. Are you ready?
I am curious to meet her. Aid me. Be my eyes. Poor Barith. I'm disappointed that Flann even considered the accusation true.
The poisoning had 2 goals. disable our army, and put the blame on Barath.
But who is behind it?
The soldiers cough blood. It must be the poison, used by a druid cult, the children of Thanu.
Who are they?
When the Christians came with sword and fire, some few druids banded together. Eventually, they vowed to destroy the Christians. They turned to mayhem and murder. Many disguise themselves and live among the villagers.
What of Deirdre and druids like her?
True druids oppose the Thanu, but they are scattered and disorganized. That is why I am so determined to help Flann to the throne as High King of Ireland. He will stamp out the children of Thanu, leaving true druids to carry on.
Tell me more about your friend.
Deirdre is a druid I have known for years. We learned together.
You were once a druid?
I was. There are many pagans and druids isolated in forests through all Ireland. This way, across the river.
This land is unsettling.
I'm unsure of the way. Follow the stone path as best you can.
Show me. Kira!
Kira, are you ready at last to return to the joys of the forest?
Deirdre, this is my friend Eivor. I'm sorry to say we've come for help.
Fea me. I hoped the auguries were mistaken. Children of Danu?
Yes. Flann's army is spitting blood.
You know what is needed.
I'd hoped you'd find another way.
What is this about?
The children of Thanu make the poison, but they also hold the key to its cure.
Amber, made from the sap of an ancient tree sacred to them. Each child of Thanu carries a shard of this amber.
Once steeped in its owner's blood, the power that is held deep within the amber is set free.
This is a somber request. How will I find one of these dark druids?
A friend of ours tried to discover the identities the Thanu have taken. He hoped to find one called the Wren.
Then that friend was killed. The Thanu are truly dangerous.
You may find something in his abandoned house, up north near Port Ollie Trading Post, at the mouth of the Ballysadir.
I will find this Wren, steep the amber in his blood, and return once I've done.
I pray the spirits guide you.
What do I know of this child of Danu? Stretch your wings, Sunin. What do I know of this child of Danu?
my eyes. I must not lose my way.
August. Bah!
My eyes, Sunan.
Let's see you, old friend.
Shit! Have to repair that.
Jora!
Not lack of shears!
Cock!
Survey the area, Sunan.
Huh?
I need your eyes, my friend. Yeah.
Need to cloak myself here.
Tell us when,
Minion. Oh, what whim, kid.
Hey, what?
Remain steadfast!
Hey, what? Hold there! Child. Die!
The curse at hiding in Tuam planned the poisoning. I will tell Deirdre and Kira and give them the amber stained in blood.
Shoot there!
Eivor. Eivor. I worried you'd come to harm.
I did not, but the Wren did.
May the Wren's blood ooze into the loamy earth and feed the forest with red milk. Give me the shard for the cure. The humors of the ancient tree live on in the amber now sparked by blood. Look, it turns deep crimson. The cure will be painful. The soldiers will writhe and plead to be killed as a mercy. But in a few hours, they will be well.
Thank the spirits of the earth.
The Wren carried a note.
A note?
The poisoning and the plan to accuse Barith was the doing of someone called the Cursed. There's a cottage in Tuam where the Cursed hides. Perhaps we can find who made the poison there.
It is a small hope, but hope still. It is nearby. We must go.
Not yet. The cure is prepared. You must deliver it as quickly as you can.
I will look for this mysterious Cursed. You take the cure to Cachalor.
3 or 4 drops on each soldier. No more.
Thank you, good friend. Goodbye. Eivor, I'll meet you under the tree outside Tuam, heading south.
The Cursed will be your second child of Danu, Eivor. There are others. Were you to bring me all their shards, I could mix you a potion that would give you the force of the blazing sun.
I will fell this one. Then I will think on the others and your mysterious son.
Before you go, there is a darkness rolling toward Kira. Please watch over her.